A warning from the Philippine president's chief legal counsel of alleged attempts to make trouble and cause embarrassment for Marcos. Juan Ponce Enrile, who helped overthrow Marcos Jr.'s father in 1986, claims on Facebook to have credible information on the supposed plots by Philippine and U.S.-based groups. Enrile said he will disclose more details in due time. But he urged Marcos's security officials to sharpen their intel gathering. Enrile's warning comes ahead of Marcos's expected trip to the U.S. next month to speak before the U.N. General Assembly in New York. In another Facebook post, Enrile also cautioned individuals against taking advantage of their seeming closeness to the president. He did not name the persons in question, but Enrile vowed they will answer to him if they continue the practice.
No new evidence from Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. as he rests his case in a long-drawn legal battle over his family's alleged ill-gotten wealth. Meanwhile, other Marcos relatives and co-defendants are given time to present their evidence. Adrian Aileen has the full story.
The camp of President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. has rested its Sandigan Bayan case involving alleged ill-gotten wealth, mostly shares of stocks in hotels amassed by his father, Ferdinand Marcos Sr. In a hearing on Wednesday, Marcos Jr.'s lawyer, Attorney Manuel Plaza, was asked by Sandigan Bayan 2nd Division Chairperson Oscar Herrera if he is considering the case rested. Plaza said yes after manifesting that they will adopt the earlier evidence submitted by other defendants to the case. The civil case involves the recovery of alleged ill-gotten wealth, which the Marcos has supposedly acquired through the improper use of funds or properties owned by the government through their associates or cronies. Defendants or accused individuals include Modesto Enriquez, Trinidad Diaz Enriquez, Rebecco Panlilio, Erlinda Enriquez Panlilio, Leandro Enriquez, and others. Based on the original complaint filed by the Office of the Solicitor General and the Presidential Commission on Good Government in 1987, the Enriquezes and Panlilios illegally acquired shares of stocks in 23 corporations during the Marcos regime. In 2009, the PCGG estimated the subject properties in the case to be worth 581 million pesos. The heirs of Enriquez and Panlilio have so far presented 3 defense witnesses. Other members of the Marcos family are also named as defendants, former First Lady Imelda Marcos and her daughters Senator Aimee Marcos and Irene Marcos Araneta have yet to present their evidence. The court is giving them time to present their evidence on September 1 and 2 and October 6. Lawyers from the government side said if they fail to present evidence, they will file a motion for the court to declare that the defendants have waived their right to present their evidence. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Education Department is eyeing to replace the pricey yet outdated laptops it bought for public school teachers. Joyce Balanzo tells us more.
The Department of Education has laid down solutions as it responds to the report of the Commission on Audit that flagged the purchase of outdated and pricey laptops given by the previous administration to teachers. DepEd spokesperson Attorney Michael Poa said they will look for some quick fix inside the department to solve the issue days before the opening of classes on August 22. Since it was the procurement service of the Department of Budget and Management that bought the gadgets, DepEd will coordinate with them to possibly invoke the warranty provision.
When we invoke the warranty provisions with the supplier, dun na natin pag-uusapan kung may magagawa pa po sila dyan o papalitan na lang yung laptops ng supplier.
Also, in the 2023 proposed budget, DepEd will request funding for more learning materials, including gadgets for teachers. The notice of award posted in the PSDBM website indicates that the project was awarded in June 30, 2021 to joint venture of Sunwest Construction and Development Corporation, LDLA Marketing and Trading Incorporation, and VS Techs Philippines Incorporated, since it was named as the lowest bidder. The laptops were purchased at 58,300 pesos each. But the Commission on Audit noted that there was indeed another choice of laptop which is faster and comes with a cheaper price of 45,531. The laptop model that the teachers received, according to COA, has a market price of only 22 to 25,000 pesos. DepEd has yet to comment on the purchase price of these gadgets.
kailangan po natin ng documentation from PSDPM. Yun po yung hinihintay natin sa PSDPM, kung ano yung naging basihan noong presyo, as well as the technical specs. So, kailangan natin makuha yung documentation. It would be unfair for us to say something without the proper documentation in hand.
Sunwest Construction and Development Corporation was also among the contractors that were mentioned in a 2014 congressional hearing when lawmakers were investigating irregularities in some DPWH projects that were also flagged by COA. Ako Bicol Party List Representative Elizalde Co, for his part, clarified that he has already divested all his interests in Sunwest since 2019. He insists his name should no longer be dragged into anything in relation to the said corporation. ABS-CBN News went to the office of Sunwest Construction and Development Corporation in Pasig City to seek their comment on the issue, but they have yet to provide one. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.